Mike Bond of MMA Junkie here at UFC 242 Media Day with Andrea Lee, who fights Jojo Calderwood in a key flyweight fight on Saturday. Before we get into this fight, I want to go back to the last one with you. You said after the fact that you thought it was one of your worst performances, one of your worst fights ever. After a little reflecting, maybe watching it back and stuff, was that like a heat of the moment comment? Can you maybe appreciate what you did in there a little more now?
Yes, most definitely. I watched the fight, and after watching it, I didn't feel the same. I felt like I did much better than I had thought I had done in the fight, and I feel like I certainly did dominate a lot more than I had felt in the moment. I'm proud of the performance, and I wouldn't want to take anything from it.
Is that just a product of you being self-critical and maybe at the moment? I'm sure maybe you want like a finish or maybe something more spectacular in a sense, and that's kind of why you were hard on yourself the night of the fight.
Well, I felt like maybe I didn't let things go enough, and I felt maybe I was a little more hesitant than normal. But I felt like after watching the fight, I did exactly what I needed to do. She was, the whole fight, she was going for the takedowns. So I was kind of cautious on the things that I was throwing because I wanted to be able to defend those takedowns and get back to my feet as quickly as I could. And that's what I did. And so I feel happy that I was able to do that, and I was able to come out with the win.
I mean, it wasn't long to sit on that fight, too. I think it was, 11, 12 days later they came to you with this fight, and it was announced. How happy did that make you when they just turned you around and booked you again so quickly?
I was extremely excited, to find out that they wanted me on this card. I didn't know anything about it. I was just in renegotiations on my contract, and then they offered me this opportunity. So, and I was like, yeah, of course. I did want to take more time off and maybe come back in October, but I feel like the fight, for September 7th just made perfect sense, because now hopefully I'll have the rest of the year to kind of enjoy and relax and maybe improve and work on some things and spend time with my daughter.
So was this, did you end up signing a new contract? Is this the first fight on your new deal?
I believe so, yes.
So how exciting is that to just, have your kind of future locked down for a little while here?
It's very exciting. I'm glad that the UFC wants me. It makes me, eager just to get in here and, keep competing and doing well and putting on great performances for everybody.
For sure. And they came to you with a fight, super quickly after the last one. What did you just think of the matchup? Was it, you were willing to fight anyone just to get back in there, or was there something about JoJo that excited you?
The fact that she's a striker, it's an exciting matchup for me. In my interview, on ESPN, they asked me maybe what would I want. I said, well, I've fought a couple of wrestlers, in my past couple of fights, I would like to fight another striker. And now I'm fighting JoJo, so it's pretty awesome.
Yeah, I think she feels the same way. I think she's really happy about having a style matchup with you. I know she wasn't too pleased with Caitlin Chookagian in their last fight. So is that kind of how you see this playing out? You guys just getting in there and it being a largely striking dominant fight?
I'm not really sure. I feel I'm very well-rounded. My wrestling is good, my grappling, my jiu-jitsu. I just think that anything could happen. I think for the most part, probably, yeah. We'll be on our feet.
Yeah, so if you win this fight, before knowing the UFC, where do you go from there? New deal and everything, it seems like this is setting you up for very big things moving forward.
I do. I feel like it's setting me up for potential title contention. I see it coming, and I want to be ready.
What about the title shot itself? Valentina Shevchenko is hanging around here, and she's here for this fight. She mentioned to you guys in an interview that this is a fight of interest to her. So do you think you win here? It's potentially that's what's next?
I do think that. I'm not 100%, I don't know what the UFC really wants to do, but in my gut, I feel like that's probably something that they're trying to push. And, I'll open it, with open. I want that. I want that to happen eventually. So, I'll open it with open arms.
Yeah, and everyone talks about her as this being this, overwhelming dominant champion and everything. When you look at her, do you see, a beatable champion there?
I think anybody is beatable.
We're ready to win.
I think everyone's beatable, at one point. So, yes, I think that I do stand a good chance.
Awesome. And last thing I wanted to ask about the cowboy hats. Do you have, I know when you talk to Donald Cerrone about this, he has, unlimited collection of these. Do you just only have a few, or do you have, a wide range that you collect from all over the place?
I don't have as many as he does. I've seen his collection. I do have a good handful, about, 7 hats. So, a couple straw, a couple felts. I lost my last felt hat. I had to get this one before I came. I feel very bad about that. But, I lost it between Las Vegas and headed home from fight week to home. But I like this hat. It's nice. It's a Stetson.
Sorry to remind you of these of the lost hat. I feel bad.
Yeah, it's all right.
All right. Well, definitely appreciate the time, Andrea. Best of luck on Saturday, and thank you.
Thank you.